this case for you guys. This one is nothing like that. And I will tell you why they call it the Jigsaw Murders. I might have thought it was even more interesting if it had puzzles like the movies, but not the case. So, tonight we are going to talk about a man named Buck Ruxton. Extravagant name that I am not even going to try to pronounce because much in demand, and Buck apparently preferred to sit at a table and sulk, which kind of reminded me of my mom and dad. My dad was an excellent dancer, side note, y'all, you know how I get. And when they would go out, my mom didn't get many chances to dance with him because all the ladies in the place wanted to dance with my dad, so my mom ended up sitting at the table a lot of the night, and then eventually not going at all. So, I wish I could have seen more of that. Anyway, on September 14th, 1935, Isabella went to Blackpool to meet with her sisters. She returned to Lancaster around 11:30 that night. She drove herself back home. And unfortunately, this was the last time that she was seen alive. Although, she had arranged to meet with her sisters again the very next day. When she returned home, something happened. She and Buck got into a fight. Apparently, he thought she was cheating, and it just ended up being one of those things that escalated very quickly. Now, unfortunately, both of these people are dead, so we don't know exactly what happened, but he strangled Isabella with his hands. And unfortunately, he was surprised by the nursemaid, Mary Jane Rogerson. She was just 19 years old. He killed her as well. And then, here's your slightly gruesome warning because I'm not going to get into all the details, but then he decides that he has to dispose of these women, and he has to do it in such a way that he will not get caught. So he takes them to a rather large clawfoot bathtub in his house. He drains them of blood, which I don't even know how you would go about doing that, and I don't want to know how you would go about doing that. And then, because he did not want to get caught, he removed every identifying marker for these ladies. This includes moles and scars, and he mutilated their fingers so that they couldn't be fingerprinted. He went above and beyond, and we'll talk about that just a little bit later. And then, he dismembered them. Of course, did this with the precision of a doctor, and that helps get him caught later on. He then wraps the body parts, over 70 in total, in newspaper, and he takes them to the boot of his car before driving them to Scotland. I believe I read that it was over between 80 and 100 kilometers. To where he drove. I got different varying numbers. Again, this happened a long time ago, so. He then scattered them in an 80-foot ravine 2 miles from parts were found. Mary Rogerson's torso is lost. They did a search of the area, and I found it really, really weird that they drafted local Boy Scouts to assist. Now, where I live, Boy Scouts are not that old. Quite high school age. When you get to high school, you become an Eagle Scout. So I don't really know how it works overseas. But in my mind, I'm seeing little 8 and 10 year olds searching, and this just, I cannot imagine the emotional scarring of this. Being young and finding parts wrapped in newspaper. It's like nightmare fuel. But there were 30 pieces in all found over the next few months, which led the press to call this case the Jigsaw Murders. The local police got cracking and they started studying what they had, which was the newspapers that the bodies were wrapped in. And one of them was a special edition dated the 15th of September, and it was sold only in Lancaster. So you basically outed yourself, sir. Investigator Jeremiah Lynch of Scotland Yard was called in to assist in the investigation. He pored over the newspaper's local subscription list, which was a vital clue in tracking down Mr. Ruxton, Dr. Ruxton, who was a regular on the delivery route. When he was initially questioned, Dr. Ruxton denied that he'd ever been to Scotland, when, in fact, he made the mistake of, while he was on his way back from disposing of the evidence, he ran over or knocked over, I read two different accounts, of a cyclist, somebody on a bike, a cyclist, and this person got his license plate number because apparently he did not stop. So, later on, he was then stopped by the police a little bit after that because he didn't, you know, that's a hit and run, man. Anyway, so this officer made record of the vehicle registration in his pocketbook, and this was vital evidence at the later trial. And I think it's pretty testament to Inspector Lynch's thoroughness. I mean, these are pre-digital times. He had to talk to a lot of people in order to find out this information. There were many components to the prosecution that were found and assembled together that all bear witness to Dr. Ruxton's guilt. The Glasgow Police Identification Bureau used newly developed fingerprint techniques to help identify the bodies. As the fingers had been mutilated, they also used the new science of photographic superimposure, matching a photo of Isabella to the shape of one of the skulls that they found. They, like, overlaid the pictures, and the match was perfect. A local dentist named James Priestley also gave evidence to identify the victims. There's another technique that they used, and I looked it up, and my brain is just not... I know someone will know, but they used the study of bugs, etymology. I feel like I'm adding a letter in there. Ugh, I should make notes when I look stuff up. Anyway, so they actually, and this is more gross to me than him dismembering them, which tells you I do way too much true crime, but they checked the maggots that infested the corpse to help pinpoint the date of death, which actually 100% makes me want to be sick. Ugh, I don't like used as a horse trough at the Lancashire Constabulary. I knew I was going to mess that up. Headquarters. There was a play based on this case. It was staged in 1975. There was a song about it. I will not be singing for you. Thank you very much. This was apparently one of the first cases to use forensic evidence such as fingerprinting, anthropology, and x-rays, which I thought was pretty cool, but I would still wish that it didn't have to happen to these poor ladies. So, he actually never admitted that he was guilty until the very, very end, and I read in one article that he sent a letter to someone that said that it was only to be revealed after he was gone, where that is when he issued his confession to murdering them and saying that he only murdered Mary because she saw what he did to Isabella. I think this case is terrible. I don't understand how you could, and I feel like I've said this before, how you could dismember somebody that you love. It just does not make sense. But I guess maybe at that point he kind of was panicking, you know, maybe he didn't mean, he was jealous, he thought she was cheating, maybe he didn't mean to kill her, he was just mad, and, you know, at that point she's dead, and then what do? And you're a prominent member of society, so you have to figure out something to do, and he's a doctor, so he knows how to do these things. It's still horrifying. I can't justify it. Anyway, that I try to think about it, I'm just like, no. Anyway, I hope that you guys are doing awesome. This is my last video of 2019. We are going to try to start 2020 off with a bang. I have a pretty interesting case in mind that I think I'm going to cover as a series right out of the gate, but we'll see. That's what I'm thinking about doing. So series are hard because I don't know if you guys like them. Do you rather have everything all in one case, or would you rather have videos kind of quickly dispersed through 4 or 5 days? Well, number one, I love the Mystery Theories series because I love all of her videos and I can just pick a playlist and hit play. But at the same time, I'm one of those people that I need to know all the things. So sometimes I'm like, wait, I wasn't done. So I just finished this book and it's the first in a series, and I looked it up and the next one doesn't come out till June, and I'm so mad. I would not have even read this book if I'd have known that, because it absolutely drives me crazy. I am the least patient person I have ever met, and I cannot wait, and I need to know what happens right now. So, I don't know, if you like series or you don't like series, please tell me down below so that I kind of know what to do. There's a lot of information, so I could try to make it into maybe 2 longer videos, but I don't know if I can squeegee it all into 1 video. I think it's too much information. So, I would also like to know what else you would like to see from this channel. Do you want solved cases? Do you like missing person cases? I try not to do. I've always tried, and it's becoming impossible at this point, to do cases that I have not seen.